स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्द गुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं
सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ऐ वेल्कम् यू आल् वित् मै लव् अण्ड् रेस्पेक्ट्स्। So many questions. Somebody has sent a huge report. Some medical study. Somebody is writing, "You have been enlightened and much more beyond. You did not have to go so much trouble to create ashrams, temples, so many programs, so much traveling and what not. Thank you so much for helping us and guiding us. Only one thing I want you to understand, do not think there was no much trouble involved. You have a wrong idea. Only the courage to go through the trouble was there. See, enlightenment does not lead to absence of troubles, it leads to presence of the courage to handle the troubles. Many are personal questions and few can be answered along with the discourse. That is the reason I did not take up all those questions. I joined LBP November 17, 18. Right from the next day, I have been coming to morning meditation every day. The physical effects are amazing. Breathing quality is improved. Swelling and puffiness is gone. Feel very energetic. Stomach is getting shrink every day. I'm doing humming such an intense way as if I'm trying to pull the whole energy up from the bottom to top. Not much results mentally yet. But I have lots of hope, love the routine schedule also. Girl who wants to do this technique, yesterday she found that she is pregnant. Do you recommend this technique for her? I think pregnant ladies, no need to do that technique. Somebody is saying, I want to commit myself, my life to you and to your mission. This is all I have. And maybe the person can meet in energy darshan. I'll talk to you and answer. Most of the questions are related to yesterday's discourse. Wanted to say a few words about it. See, the yesterday's discourse was a very intimate opening of intimate experience. I cannot give any further explanation about it. The moment I start giving further explanation, the beauty of the whole thing will be lost, which I don't want to do. Whatever you understood, that much only you can understand. Relax from it. Some people are asking many technical questions. How come you felt that oneness? And we also go through the ups and downs, the pain and joy, but we are not feeling that oneness. Maybe you are not exhausted completely, understand? You have to go through the bottom line of pain. You have to go through the bottom line of the depression. Then, naturally, your mind will completely lose the hope. It will not give you any hope to continue to survive. Then, the ultimate no mind state can become your life. Let's enter into today's sutra. 89th sutra. Here, Mahadeva is addressing Devi. Shiva is addressing Devi. Beloved, at this moment, let mind, knowing, breath, form be included. One more Ananda Sutra. Understand? One more very strong initiation, very strong click. When I say click, just logically, if you allow this word to go inside, that is enough, that will shake your whole logic. With a simple logic, whatever you understand, with that understanding, if you allow this understanding to go inside, it will shake all the other understandings. It's like a, it will completely loosen up the programming, a conditioning which you did to yourself or which society has done to you. Beloved, at this moment, let mind, knowing, breath, form be included. Just few words about knowing, breath, form. These three. You have three levels of body. Of course, all the great masters of Vedic tradition emphasized on understanding of this Dehatraya, three bodies which you carry. The physical body which you are carrying now and experiencing this physical world. Second, the dream body which you carry in the dream state and through which you experience the dream world. Third, Sushupti, the deep sleep state. In that, the body and the world both are one and the same. Here, in the waking state, the body and the world distance is more. Not only you see the world, you can suspect, you can doubt, you can analyze. But in the dream state, you will have a body and you will have a world. But the gap is too less. You cannot suspect the dream world. The moment you suspect or doubt, you will come out of the dream. Understand? In the waking state, you can suspect, logically analyze, doubt, still you will continue to see this world. In the dream state, the moment you doubt what you are seeing is a dream or waking, you will wake up. How can this be logical? The moment you bring that question, you will wake up. Because the distance between the dream body and the dream world is less. It is not so much like this world. In this world, the distance between your waking body and waking world is more. The dream state, it is very less. For example, in the dream state, you will see suddenly a horse coming towards you. By the time it comes near you, you will see the horse has turned into your friend. By the time it comes almost to touch you, you will see it has become a tree. And logically you cannot doubt, how can a horse become a friend and the tree? You cannot doubt. If you have the intelligence to doubt, you will wake up from the dream. The dream state will not continue. In this world, if anything happens this way, you can doubt, you can logically analyze, but still the world will continue to exist, because the gap between the seer and the seen is more. In the second dream state, the gap between seer and seen is less. A logic or doubt cannot be used to analyze the gap between the seer and the seen. In the third, deeper level, there is no difference. That is why in the sukshma, the karana sarira, the causal body, the body which you experience in the deep sleep, the body and the world, both are one and the same. There is no difference. Only a person who exhausted all these three shariras, or who is able to unclutch from all these three shariras, can become enlightened, can achieve enlightenment. Here, by using these three words, knowing, breath, form, Mahadeva is mentioning the essence of this three sharira. This three shariras essence, actually the form is the essence of the physical sharira. Breath is the essence of your dream body. By handling your breath, by balancing your breath, you can straight away alter, censor, postpone, edit your dreams. Because the whole dream body is nothing but the play of prana on the unconscious energy. It's like how breeze creates waves on the water. The flow of prana in your system creates dreams on your unconscious mind. The person who is able to handle all these three, form is physical world, breath is the source of the dream world, knowing, but there is no knower. That is the essence of deep sleep state. Understand? In the deep sleep, there is knowing, but there is no knower. That is why nothing is known. Only with the knower, even if knowing is happening, there will be something known. Because there is no knower, even if the knowing is happening, there is nothing known. That is why when you come out, you say, nothing is known. I don't know where I was. I don't know what it was. Person who can handle all these three qualities, all these three dehas, it's actually three qualities, sattva, rajas, tamas, who can handle all these three qualities and go beyond, he achieves the enlightenment. Understand? By listening to the sutra, the sutra may look like a nitya sutra, which you need to practice, or dhyana sutra, which you need to practice at particular point of your time. No, it is neither a nitya sutra, which you need to practice whole day, nor dhyana sutra, which you need to practice at particular point. It is Ananda Sutra. No need to practice. Understanding is the only thing needed. Dehatraya. Understanding about the Dehatraya. Understanding about the Avastatraya. Of course, Dehatraya, Avastatraya, Kalatraya. All these three is directly connected to this sutra, I can say the sutra is the essence of all these three. Kalatraya means three time, past, present and future. Dehatraya means the physical body, subtle body and karana sarira, causal body. And avastatraya, three states which you experience. The jagrat, swapna, sushupti, waking state, dream state and deep sleep state. Just a simple, clear understanding about this three state will shift your attention to the fourth state. Understand? Whenever you understand the futility of what you are having, you will start looking for something beyond what you are having. Analyzing these three states and understanding will automatically inspire you to look beyond this four state. That is why I tell you, this is Ananda Sutra, means just understand, automatically it will shift your attention to beyond this three state. To wake up from the dream, you don't need any technique. Very beautiful story by Ramana Maharshi. Somebody goes to Bhagavan and asks, Bhagavan, what is the technique to become enlightened? Will the service to society help? Or breathing, controlling the breath will help? Or should I do meditation? Should I do this? Should I do that? Bhagavan beautifully says in a story, one person is seeing a dream as if a tiger is chasing him. And he is shouting, tiger is chasing me, save me, save me. If you give him a weapon from the waking state, you see, he is dreaming and he is shouting in the dream, means he is shouting in the sleep. Tiger is chasing me, save me, save me. You are sleeping in the next room, suddenly you bring a weapon and give him. Will it be of any help? No. All you need to do, save him from that suffering, is just tell him, hey, wake up. That's all. Nothing else is needed. Nothing else can help. All you need to do is wake up. Tell him to wake up. No other technique will help. No other method can help. How the waking up happens? The attention, instead of being on the scene, when it turns towards the seer, he wakes up. This understanding about the avastatraya, these three states of consciousness, I can say three states of mind. We can't use the word consciousness because consciousness has no states. It's beyond. Only in the Western psychology they use the word unconscious, subconscious and conscious and superconscious. Conscious is always super. It's beyond super. It cannot be. Maybe you can use the word for mind. If you understand the three states of the mind, trivikalpa, your whole attention will turn towards the seer and the awakening will happen automatically. Understand? Only a person who has crossed all these three before leaving the body is enlightened. There are very few rare souls who leave the body after exhausting all these three, but even after that they descend, they assume a body. They are called incarnations, avatara. Understand? Based on the state in which you stayed most of your time, that is the state will automatically erupt when you are leaving the body. If you stayed most of your time in the waking, clear state,
If that was the strongest experience of your life, that was the essence of your life, you will see when you leave the body, only that will come up. If dream state is the state you spent most of your time, or you feel that is the essence of your life, that will come up if you leave, when you leave the body. If deep sleep state was the real experience you enjoyed, most of your life you spent only in that state, then naturally when you were about to die, you will fall into coma. Understand? Based on the person's death, we can say how he lived. If a person can leave the body consciously, he lived consciously. The majority of his life was conscious, means in the waking state. Understand? All the time you are able to move your body and mind as you want, do not think you are waking state. No. Many time you will be driving, but you do not know in which road you are driving. Only when you reach your office and park the car, suddenly you remember last 30 minutes you drove. At least 200 decisions you would have made to drive, right, left, stopping in the red signal. 200 decisions you have made without being aware, you are driving, you are doing something. So all the moments in which you are able to move your hands or leg as you want does not mean you are in waking state. Second, the dream state. If you lived most of your time in the dream state, means daydreaming and night dreaming. If your body is moving as you want, but your mind is also moving as it want, the accounts will go only to dream state. That hours cannot be considered as a waking state. The person who spent most of his time in dream state, you will see him talking, blabbering, uttering some illogical words before he dies. Not only that, he will fall into the dream state and leave the body. And the person who lived most of his time in the deep sleep state, potato couch we call, who did not do anything else except eating and seeing the TV. And this kind of people, they naturally land in coma before they leave the body, and leave the body unconsciously. Only a person who lived, understood and left all these three bodies relaxes into enlightenment. Very rarely, person who has become enlightened again lands in the body out of deep compassion and love. That is what we call avatar incarnations. Person who died with the waking body, he enters. Of course, if you are died in waking body or dream body or deep sleep body, naturally you will take birth immediately. The next body, you will start searching and entering into the next body. Person who died in the waking state, with the waking mood, he will enter into the body, he will enter into the world with another one body, which is created in a normal way, with a physical relationship, with a physical intercourse, with the ordinary sex, he will catch that kind of body and land. And the next, the person who left the body in the dream state, he will select the body which is created by the tantric intercourse, means the meditative parents. Even though there was a physical relationship, there was a lot of meditativeness into that. Both of them were real seekers, spiritual persons. In that kind of womb he will enter. A person who left the body with a deep sleep state, in the deep sleep state, he will naturally enter into animalistic, means completely the move or the thinking, physical and mental movements are unaware. Animalistic means it may not be four-legged animal, even two-legged animal it can be. It can be even human animals, means who have the human body, but the pratyagatma chaitanya, the individual consciousness awakening has not happened. He will choose that kind of parents and land in that kind of body. Person who has left the body after disconnecting, unclutching from all the four sarira, the enlightened beings, if they land in the body, they will land in the immaculate conceptions. They will take up a body, they will land in a body which is created not by any intercourse or any physical relationship. Understand? Looks very illogical. Kundi experimented with this and gave birth to Karna. Kundi did not carry Karna 9 months. And all other 5 kids, all Panjabandavas and Karna, all the 6 have been given birth by Kundi in this way, in the way of immaculate conception, means created without any physical relationship. The science was alive, science existed, there is a possibility, and even though logically it is very difficult to understand or relate with, the science existed. Even now, the incarnations, people who are left after enlightenment, left the body after enlightenment, they land this kind of sariras. There may not have been any physical relationship, but suddenly the body will start getting created in the mother's womb and the child is there. If you see the modern day incarnations like Ramakrishna, when Ramakrishna took birth, his father was too old. But the story, even the reminiscence says, when she felt she is carrying Ramakrishna, the Ramakrishna's mother, the father was far away, somewhere. It's like from a Shivalinga, a light entered, and she knows she is carrying a child now. Understand? Person who left the body beyond all these 3 shariras lands by creating a body which is not related to any physical relationship. May not the physical relationship exist, but he knows how to create a new body, and he lands in the superconscious body. Very difficult for a logical Western mind to relate with. The whole Christianity is taunted, made fun of, what not. It went through so much of problem just because of this one concept, the immaculate conception. Of course, to understand is there is something beyond our understanding. If we have that much of patience, look into it, try to understand, otherwise at least relax from it. The essence of what I try to tell you, understand all these 3 layers, understand all these 3 shariras and look into it. The moment you understand, your whole attention will turn towards the seer. It will neither be in the knowing, nor be in the breath, nor be in the form. If your intelligence is based on constantly knowing, you will be dead. That is why the intellectual philosophers are so impractical. Because most of your energy will be centered, most of your energy will be bound in the karana sarira, means the sushupti, deep sleep state.
That is why the more you become intellectual, a greater philosopher you became, the connection with the reality is disconnected. You became so impractical. A small story. Few philosophers have been arrested and put in jail. And all of them somehow, because no other way, started agreeing on one point that all of them should escape. For that agreement, I don't know how many months discussion went on. And they planned, developed some plan, understanding. They even went up to the level of making a duplicate key. Made a duplicate key also. This much work being done by group of philosophers is unimaginable. Miracle by itself. I always tell people, one head, 1,000 hand, work will be done. Philosopher means 10 head, no hand. If there are one or two hands, they will be beating each other. They will be fighting with each other and beating each other. And no hand will be left to do any work. Anyhow, these guys went up to the level of making a key. Everything was set, plan. According to the plan, tonight they will open the door and give a signal. All others will come to the door and run away. Two people, they went. Not only they did not give any signal, they did not come back also. These guys are waiting, waiting, waiting. After 2 hours, they slowly came back, tired, sweating. All these guys asked, what happened? These two philosophers who went to open the door and they are supposed to give signal for other guys to escape. They came back and said, no, I think we need to drop the plan. Today we cannot escape. These guys asked, why? The fools forgot to lock. Understand? Philosopher cannot be spontaneous. Everything has to be according to the plan. And even if one line in the plan is missing, over. Nothing can be done. Too much away from practical realm, practical reality. They can never be practical. That is why traditionally the Lakshmi will never be near Saraswati. The wealth will never get accumulated with the philosophers because they will become too impractical. For wealth, you need to be completely practical, like a Krishna. But the philosophers more and more become like a Brahma. Too much away from the reality. That is why not many temples. He's sitting in somewhere and something is doing. Finally ends up creating this messy world. Anyhow. Too much of head moves you away from the practical reality, moves you away from the exact truth. That is why knowing, if you are centered continuously on knowing, most of your energy will be blocked in the deep sleep, sushupti sarira. The second, understand? Always logical people think they are very intelligent. They think, that's all. Not. Logic means what? Analyzing, 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 segregating, segregating, segregating. And when you can't segregate, when you can't dissect, when you can't analyze anymore, that part you call yourself as a specialty, a specialist in that part. In India, if you even get some specialist for one organ, for eye or a dentist or any lungs, that itself is a big thing. Here I saw even in the one part, there are specialists even for inside.
For eyes, right eye, left eye. And inside the right eye, there is so many specialists. Analyzing. And finally, when you can't analyze anymore, call yourself as a specialty of that part. Specialist in that part. That's the logic. Understand, in the Vedic tradition, logic is not dissecting or analyzing, it is integrating and evolving. Integrating and evolving. The whole language is different. If you are knowing based, most of your energy will be inside the sushupti. Because for knowing, you need only logic, no need for visualization. With visualization, you will have intelligence, not intellect. Here, Mahadeva says only about intellect. Intelligence will be awakened when you go beyond all these three bodies, not with any one of this body. Knowing, intellect, logic means the deep sleep state, sushupti, away from practicality. Second, breath. Understand one important thing about breath. When you are aware, it leads you to the more and more awareness and becomes the key to open solutions from the problems. Understand? Many people come and ask me, Swamiji, what is the solution for this problem, that problem? Today somebody has put a question, a long assuming supposed question. Assume a person performs a murder due to being not aware like an animal. Let's assume after a 5-year trial, the judge awards him a death sentence. Again, assuming he transformed himself during those 5-year trial period and become completely conscious, similar to a god, is awarding a death sentence a good thing at the present moment for the past act? Would that person have another birth? Now you have to assume your answer, that's all. Understand? Many people come and ask me, like this assumed questions. I always tell them, understand, if you are assuming questions, two things, either it is your problem and you don't want to tell it is your problem, you don't want to reveal, or one more thing, you are just trying to create some questions, you are just trying to create some imaginative questions. Maybe you are trying to write a novel, crime novel. You are trying to bring some complications. Understand? The assumed questions cannot be answered. People ask me, no. If this problem happens, what should I do? Now I tell you, this is not fun. This is an exact truth. Any problem. See, problem is a mother who is carrying a solution child inside her. Any problem. Problem is a mother who is carrying a solution child inside her. Pregnant with the solution. How to bring the child out? How to do the delivery? Conscious breath. When you are aware of your breath, when you handle the problem, when the problem comes in front of you, just be aware of your breath. The aware breath, breath awareness can open spontaneously the solution. Breath awareness is the way to deliver the solution baby from the problem mother. All problems carry solutions inside, and an important thing, your awareness can open the spontaneity. Can open the spontaneity. Spontaneity is a quality awakened by awareness, breath awareness. Here, If you are centered on breath but not aware, understand? If you are centered on breath with awareness, you will fall into turiya, the fourth state. But if you are just centered on breath but not aware, you will see your thoughts will be just like a breeze. Sometimes cyclonic, sometimes slow, sometimes different kinds of wind, but not under anybody's control. Not under anybody's control. Breath plus awareness is a controlled condition. Breath without awareness is a wild changes happening. You do not know when you will have tsunami. You do not know when you will have Katrina. You do not know when you will have breeze. Nothing is under your control. It just moves. It just moves. And neither you know nor you can be aware. That is what is happening in your dream state. You do not know when you will have good dream, when you will have bad dream. If at all you can control, I know what kind of dreams you will be having constantly. You do not know when a snake will chase you, when a lion will chase you, when an elephant will chase you, when your spouse will chase you. You do not know. Means the breath without awareness. Mahadeva says very beautifully, he gave a beautiful technique to penetrate your dream. The early few sutras. Person who maintains the breath awareness in the waking state will enter into the dream state with the same awareness and will be able to handle the dream. Understand? Able to handle the dream is the period you will express siddhis. Let me give some more deeper clarity. Ability to handle the dream. See, if you have experienced at some time that you remember, you are aware, you are seeing dream, but you are not completely out of the dream. You are aware, you are seeing the dream, and for a few moments you are trying to alter some of the things in the dream. But once you do 4 or 5 decisions in the dream with awareness that you are dreaming, you will wake up. By the time the awareness, it is dream, will become more, then you will wake up. That 4 or 5 moment, you will be able to change things in the dream. Understand? Same way, when you are trying to wake up from this state to enlightenment, slowly, understand, whenever a seer becomes strong, he can handle the scene. He can change things in scene. If a seer is too strong, he cannot change, he will wake up. That is what happens in the dream. In the dream, when slowly seer is becoming aware of the scene, he can change few things. By the time he changes, the awareness increases, he will wake up. Same way only in this world. When a seer starts getting strong by seeking, whenever you start seeking enlightenment, slowly the seer is becoming strong. When a seer becomes strong, you will have now ability to change the scene. That is what I call Ashtama Siddhis. Ashtama Siddhis, different miracle powers expressed by Patanjali, starts expressing out of you. Because the seer has become strong, it is easy to play with the scene. But by the time you do few miracles, the attention towards the seer, if it gets strong, see, miracles can be performed if it gives you the clarity that this is nothing. Two things. Your dreams can be made to reality if it leads to the clarity that reality itself is a one more dream, not otherwise. Your dreams can be made to reality if it leads you to the experience the reality is nothing but one more dream. Then it is worthy of making into reality. If you are making your dreams into reality and caught in that so-called reality, then they are not worthy of making it, worthy of becoming real. Whenever the seer becomes strong and you are able to move the things which you are seeing, that's what I call siddhis, miracle powers. Some rare fortunate souls, that siddhis will lead them towards the center, means again to the seer. Then you will be completely awakened. You will stop changing, you will just get awakened. You will become enlightened. For some time, the attention will be diverted towards the scene and they will be continuously wasting and spending their time in changing the scenes, means doing miracles. If the attention is too much engrossed, involved in the scene, the connection with the seer comes down, means the intensity of the person is coming down, then the miracle powers will be lost. That's what happens. Understand? How the miracle powers come and goes. This is the science. When the intensity of the seer increases, then the scene, the seer will have intelligence and ability to alter the scene as he wants. If he does not bother about those powers and continues to increase the intensity of the seer, he will become enlightened. If he does not increase the intensity and if his intention and the energy is turned towards the scene, he will be able to play the game for quite some time till too much of his attention goes to the scene. If too much of attention goes to the scene, naturally his intensity on the seer will come down and he will lose the power which he gained to play with the scene. Understand? The awareness of breath leads you to this very space. If you are aware of your breath in the waking state, you will become aware of your breath in the deep sleep, in the dream state also. If you can be aware of your breath in the dream state, you will be able to alter the dreams. If you are able to alter the dreams and still you continue to be aware of your breath, you will be able to alter things in the deep sleep state, sushupti. If you are able to handle your sushupti because of your breath awareness, now you will be able to handle the jagrat, the waking state. Means the intensity of the seer is increasing. This is the dangerous period where you need to really be guided by the enlightened being. Otherwise, the small powers will give so much of excitement. I have seen poor guys playing with small toys, small powers, and do not realize the amazing experience or the reality which is waiting. If you don't have the proper guidance, naturally you will be lost. You will be lost in those small magics, small miracles. Vivekananda is very careful about the siddhis, miracle powers, the ability to change the scene. Whenever he sees some disciple gets that power, first thing he will do is he will make them eat fish, because with fish your nerves will become so dull, you will lose the power. The power will be taken away. First thing he will tell them, hey, go and eat Ganga phala. Means flower from Ganga. Fish is the flower from Ganga. And finish off. So that you will not be distracted towards the scene. You will be centered towards the seer. Understand? intensity, feeling connected deeper and deeper with the seer is the essence. When you understand the futility, understand? When you understand the futility of all these three states and trying to change the scene in all these three states, your whole attention will fall on the seer. If you think there is some utility in all these three states, you will be engaged in it. If you realize the futility of all these three states, your whole attention will turn towards the center, the seer, and the awakening will happen. All Mahadeva means in the sutra, through the sutra, understand and turn towards the center. No technique, understand? If you ask, how can I do? Please give us some technique. Then go for Nitya Sutras. There are so many Nitya Sutras. To give you the technique to turn your attention towards the center, let me describe. Nitya Sutra means which you need to understand, internalize, practice whole day. Dhyana Sutra means which you need to internalize, practice at particular point of your life, part of your life. Ananda Sutra means which you need to just internalize, no need to practice. Means these are the clicks given by Mahadeva to the intense seekers, to the real sincere seekers. Many people come and claim, I am real sincere seeker, give me experience. It's like, not only that, they will literally demand and sometimes they will complain also, I think you are not able to give, that's why you are giving all the reasons. I tell them, okay, anyhow. No. Anyhow, they have a right to tell, nothing wrong. The moment you sit in the throne, you open yourself to any question, you open yourself to anybody's comments. That's okay. But understand, now this is the way to check your sincerity, your intensity. If this understanding clicks in you, in the dream state, to wake you up, it does not take more than one click. This is a dream. That's all. You are awakened. Means you are really intense. During nightmare, a very wild dream, where you are really with your spouse. Just one thought, one click. This is a dream. You are awakened. You are out. Same way, if you are intense in this dream, one click, this sutra is enough. You will be out. You will be out. If you think, no, I need some more technique, then you are not really going through nightmare or intense dream. You are just having some casual flow of thoughts. Sometime, in the dream state, you will see without any clarity, some casual black and white shows will be going on around you. You will neither feel like watching it nor feel like coming out of it. If you are in that kind of dream, you are just wasting your time. You are just wasting your time. I have seen sometime in India, 30 years these guys will do the government job in same office and same house. These fellows are in that kind of dreams. Neither they will go down nor they will go up, wasting buffaloes. Useless. Please do not be in that state. Understand? If you are in that state, then this click will not happen. It will not be a sharp, strong shift. Mahadeva is very confident. He says very clearly, any intense seeker who is waiting for that fire, fire means the initiation from the master, understanding, a strong click. This one click is enough. He says, beloved, at this moment he is addressing Devi. That's why he is saying, beloved. Of course, all of us are embodiment of Devi. He is not just talking to Devi. Keeping Devi in the front, he is talking to all of us. Krishna did not talk just to Arjuna. Keeping Arjuna in the front, he is speaking to all of us. If he has spoken just to Arjuna, then why should we bother about him? Forget about it. It is some conversation between two friends. Over. Keeping Arjuna in the front, he is talking to all of us. Here, Mahadeva is talking to all of us, keeping Devi in the front. He says, beloved, at this moment, let mind, knowing, breath, form be included. Understand? A very powerful word, included. Means, only the seer who is seeing can include all these three. Only a person who is seeing this waking state, who is going through dream state, and who is going through the deep sleep state, can include all these three. Now, your identity, which you are experiencing during waking state, if you are a doctor, lawyer, engineer, whatever, your identity which you are experiencing in the waking state cannot include all the three. You can include only the waking state, because only this is your experience. Only if you are aware of the identities which you are carrying in all these three and enjoying, if you have caught the thread line, central line, a deeper thread of all these three, understand? Waking, dream, and deep sleep. Only when you catch the thread of all these three, suddenly you will be able to include all the three. One important thing, people come and ask me, no, Swamiji, I don't think in the deep sleep I am aware. Then who is the person who comes back and says, it was deep of all these three state, all these three. If you are aware of the identity of all these three, you are conscious enough, your seeking is intense enough to be answered, to be initiated, to be blessed. If you are not already aware of all these three states, if you have not experienced all these three states with the same identity, then naturally, you need to now intensify your seeking. An intense seeker will carry the identity about himself throughout all these three. If you have even experienced once or twice in the dream state, suddenly you are remembering you are something beyond the identity which you think as you in the dream state. I have seen the seekers going through this experience. In the dream state, they will be dreaming, but suddenly they will identify themselves with the identity of the waking state. Then they will think, this is too small thing. Nothing. How many of you had that experience of waking state identity in the dream state? Understand? Then you have an intensity. Your seeking is intense, then this sutra can straight away click with you. There are some more people who carry that same awareness even to the deep sleep, even to the swapna. For them, the very understanding of this three state, suddenly they will come back to the center to awaken themselves to the fourth state, to the Turiya. A small story. One day early morning, a Zen master started crying. The moment he came out of his bed, he started crying. Disciples asked, why are you crying? Master very beautifully says, yesterday night I dreamt that I became a butterfly. The disciples are asking, for that you don't have to cry. Now you are okay. You are sitting in front of us. Why are you bothered? Why are you crying? He says very beautifully, I do not know whether I dreamt that I became butterfly or that butterfly is dreaming now it has become master. Understand, it is true. Very rare few individuals can carry the intensity to have a same unconnected, unclutched or undisturbed identity. If you can carry a disc, see, if you can carry a connected, a straight, undisturbed, unbroken identity throughout these three states, you are a seeker. The Pratyagatma Chaitanya, individual consciousness is awakened. The Pratyagatma Chaitanya Jakratam has happened. These are all some of the Sanskrit technical terms. I always wanted to express or remember the Sanskrit words also, because I want all of you to know there are many non-portable things in the Vedic tradition. Understand? It means a person to experience the ultimate truth, if somebody says you don't have to have any lifestyle change, you can have it like a pill, then forget about him. People who are selling the portable knowledge without emphasizing the importance and sanctity of the non-portable part are not just using the Vedic tradition, they are abusing the Vedic tradition. That's the reason I wanted Sanskrit word also to be continuously put in record. Of course, just speaking in Sanskrit, you may not be able to connect or relate with it. That's why I'm giving the English translation. But there are so many Sanskrit words which cannot be translated. If you have a chance, do not miss to study the original words and the original meaning, because whenever I give a meaning, I am only giving one dimension, one part of that word. When you translate the word Brahmacharya into celibacy, it's only one dimension of that Brahmacharya, not the whole Brahmacharya. Exactly the technical translation of the word Brahmacharya means living like God. Only one part is celibacy, means the freedom, independence. The whole word Brahmacharya cannot be translated into word celibacy. Same way, so many words, Sanskrit words, cannot be translated. If you can study little bit, it can open new doors and open deeper and deeper understandings. Sanskrit is the language. She is the Veda Mata. She reveals our reality and truth based on your spiritual growth. If you evolve yourself to the next level, she will reveal the new meaning. The same line, you will see the new meaning. She is a living language created by living beings. Out of life, she comes out. That is why she only increases the life in you. She only creates life in you. The language came out of the living beings and creating intense life. She is living energy, living language, not dead language. If it is a dead language, you can have only one meaning. At the most, two meanings, poetic and linguistic. Means when it is used in prose, one meaning, and when it is used in poem, another one meaning. That's all. But with Sanskrit, the more you evolve, the more truths will be revealed. The more details will be revealed. Pratyagatma Chaitanya Jakratam. The individual consciousness awakening means individual consciousness is the thread which is running through all these three states. Jakrat, Swapna, Sushupti. Knowing, breath and form. Form is this body. Breath is the dream body. And knowing is the deep sleep state. Knowing without knower is a deep sleep, Sushupti. Breath without awareness is the dream state. Form without the person who is enjoying the form is waking state. Form with the person who is enjoying the form, the person who is enjoying the form is formless. Because you are not this body, you are able to see this body. If you are this body, just this body, you cannot see this body. Anything you are able to see, it is not you. The form with formlessness, breath with awareness, knowing with knower is enlightenment. Knowing without knower, breath without awareness, form without formlessness is death. That is what is unconscious life. That is what, I don't even call that as life, waiting for death. There are so many people just waiting for death. It has not happened and does not have courage to quicken it or make it happen. That is not life. The life, the knowing without knower, breath without awareness, and form without formlessness is dragging, waiting for death, not life. Knowing with knower, breath with awareness, form with formlessness is enlightenment. Mahadeva says, include all these three. Means, he is saying, intensify your awareness, intensify your attention towards the awareness which is beyond these three. Then you will catch the thread which is running through all these three states. Understand? Again, I am emphasizing, it is not Nitya Sutra which you need to practice whole day, not Dhyana Sutra which you need to practice part of your day, it is Ananda Sutra. Understand? Just simple understanding is enough. Ananda Sutra means Shravana leads to Nididhyasana. Listening leads to expression. In Vedic tradition, three things are there. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. Shravana means internalizing, listening and internalizing. Manana means contemplating. Maybe some sutras you need to contemplate 24 hours, whenever you remember you. Some sutras you may need to contemplate on particular time, like morning half an hour or evening half an hour. That's what is called. If you need to contemplate 24 hours, it is called Nitya Sutra. If you need to contemplate on particular time, morning and evening, then it is called Dhyana Sutra. Understand, if you don't need to contemplate at all, straight away Shravana, listening and internalizing, leads to expression, Nididhyasana, it is called Ananda Sutra. Nididhyasana means expressing that reality in your life. Shravana, internalizing, Manana, meditating, contemplating, Nididhyasana, expressing the reality. This sutra does not need Manana. Just Shravana, internalizing, straight away makes Nididhyasana, expression to happen. How to understand and internalize? Now, the essence, the knowing, your deep sleep state, breath, your dream state, the form, your waking state, all these three as a base, that is you. You are experiencing all these three. Turn your attention to that person who is experiencing all these three and include, the moment you turn the attention intensely towards you, who is experiencing, no technique can be given. There are so many techniques, who am I and all those things. Ramana Maharishi's techniques, so many. That and all is a Nitya Sutra. You can practice those techniques. But here Mahadeva says, no technique is needed because this Ananda Sutra, it is given to a person who is evolved, intense. If you are that intense, catch the glimpse. Means, turn the attention towards you. You will see what Mahadeva says, the ultimate experience, the Shiva consciousness will happen this moment in you. If you feel you are not that intense, then take up the Dhyana Sutras to bring your awareness to the self. There are hundreds of, there are many Dhyana Sutra, Nitya Sutra, Mahadeva has spoken. Take up any one of them and intensify. So now the essence, mind which is in front of you, through which you are seeing, knowing which is behind you, which you are using to know further and further, breath which is like a connecting mechanism, form which is your base, include everything through the seer, you who is beyond all these three. If you catch the click, if you had the click or initiation, yes, what he says is right. If you had the click, try including, try to be all inclusive. If you are not able to catch that click, contemplate. Then start the Nididhyasana, means go to Nitya Sutras. You will see the promise or the technique which Mahadeva is giving, or the experience which Mahadeva is promising will happen in you. At this moment, let mind, knowing, breath, form be included. Let you achieve this truth. Let's gather for next session. Thank you. Next session, we'll have the next truth. I can say Mahadeva is taking us to the deeper level in the next sutra. We'll see the next sutra in the next session. Thank you. Few of your questions, then we'll enter into the next sutra. Your divine pure love has brought me back here today and receive your true yogic alchemy of understanding enlightenment. I wholeheartedly and soulfully would like to fully join your divine missions in every way. At this present time, please give me your divine guidance that I need to handle all the challenges and start with your divine work. You can ask the energy session. I'll see individually, give you some idea or some words. Same person, some personal question, please ask in the energy session. May you know who is the person? Lily Akpam. Okay, in the energy session you can ask. At this time I am aware of my breathing is not disturbing the intense tingling. I do not want to come out of this state. It has been happening more often and is in the middle of the night too, and so many times seeing you with your Trishul helping me that state. Is it all my imagination? It cannot be imagination. Relax. Imagination will lead to suffering. But here you are writing, Swamiji, I seems to start feeling the tingling feeling, growing intensity and deep smile on my face. Deep smile can never come by imagination. It can come only by experience. Imagination, you will create only suffering, because you are trained to produce suffering. You are trained to create suffering. If you are not creating suffering, you are not imagining. Did Shiva take birth on planet Earth? What was it before or after we were on Earth? Why do we forget who we are? Do we remember who we are when not in physical form, or is some expansion process? Wow. You are practically asking the whole business secret. Maybe you have to become partner to know so much. So invest your life, then we will share. We will see. Because you are practically asking the password for the bank locker. The problem is, unless you have an account in that particular bank, even if I describe, you will not be able to understand. I'll say, take right, go to the third locker, open the third locker and take the key and go to the left, and unless you have seen the bank, you will not even be able to use, even if I give answer. Means, unless you have some intensity and commit your life to the spiritual life and practice, even if I give the answer, it will be useless. It will be useless. Actually, yesterday, after the discourse, some of the disciples came and asked me, the ashramites, Swamiji, if we could have had the picture of Arunachala temple, we would have understood more visually. But now, no need for understanding with the picture, because the description was so clear. What you understood is enough. And suddenly one devotee reminded me, Swamiji, then that same experience happened on January 1st night. Because 31st night, I entered the temple. One day I was lying there, means the crying and exhausting. That night, first time yesterday I realized, yes, January 1st. Again, January 1st night. Actually, I came to know even about the date, because in the night time nobody will be allowed in the temple. Because it was a function date, they were cleaning. The preparation was, see, January 1st morning, the huge crowd will come. So the watchmen, in India, security person and the worker will be both same. Security person only will clean. Now, it is the cleaning also is their responsibility. And these guys, they need people for holding the pipe, or the hose pipe. So they will allow all the kids inside to hold the pipe, so that it's a huge place, not a small area. 27-acre granite built-up area. 27-acre granite has to be cleaned with water. It's not a joke. So they will allow the kids to hold the pipe. We will have to be holding that pipe and continuously we have to walk. And it's not a small area. Don't think temple means seeing our temple. Forget about it. Only the murti is replica, but not the temple. It's like a... you have to do so many round even to clean once. So that is the way I was allowed. Now, after remembering all those points, suddenly yesterday we remembered, yes, again, January 1st night was the time when the experience landed. Anyhow, even this experience when I verbalize, you are not able to catch unless you see that place. If you have seen that place, you will be able to catch more deeper. Same way, even if I give the password, the answer to all the questions, what you are asking, why we forget who we are and all those things, you will not be able to catch. Just understand only one thing. You are not expressing your potential, possible truth. Things which can happen to you has not happened. Just remember that and start working towards it. All these questions will be answered as a byproduct or the side effect on the way. That is the best way to have the answers. Let's enter into the next sutra. Touching eyeballs as a feather, lightness between them opens into heart and there permeates the cosmos. This is the Dhyana Sutra. I can say, even in the Dhyana Sutra, very powerful technique. Dhyana Sutra for the person who has really grown in sensitivity, who is really sensitive, understand? Unfortunately, the society does not want sensitive people. It wants laborers. It wants dry intellectuals. If you are a dry intellectual, you will be paid everywhere. Professors. It wants dry people. But it does not want you to retain sensitivity in your life, because sensitive people are difficult to handle. They will be free. Understand? When I say sensitive, I want you to understand the meaning clearly, not weak. People think sensitive means being weak and being open to everything. No, Sensitive means being strong and being aware of everything, not being open to everything. Being open means something like anybody can invade you, anybody can bulldoze you. No, that is not sensitivity. Actually, if you are not sensitive, anybody can bulldoze you. Because you will not be sensitive, somebody is bulldozing you. Only after they enter your bedroom, you will suddenly wake up and say, oh, I think they entered my house. But they came and did their job and went away long before. A real sensitive person will be aware. Will be aware means you will know exactly what is coming, and you will know when to say yes and when to say no. Unable to say no does not mean sensitivity. That is egoistic. Understand? You may be having other way idea. No, person who is not able to say no is egoistic. It is ego. Only egoistic idiot will not be able to say no when he can't. See, having the clarity, when I can say yes, I'll say. When I can't say yes, I'll say no. This is a clarity. This is sensitivity. You see, the person who is that sensitive will always say yes to the right thing, always will say no to the wrong thing. But the problem is, people who think themselves as sensitive, they will say no to master. No, I have seen many idiots who say no to master, they think they are sensitive, or they think they are very intelligent. No. But they will say yes to all the useless things. When I use the word sensitivity, being aware and ready to be spontaneously reacting or responding. A spontaneous person will not be closed. He will be completely sensitive and open. Here, this technique is for people who are sensitive, who are aware, who are open to respond spontaneously, who is not having a fixed, clear-cut ideas and frames, who is not working with those kind of mental frame, who is open, who is available. Let me describe the technique. Touching eyeballs as a feather, lightness between them opens into heart and there permeates the cosmos. I can say, Mahadeva is powerfully putting you back to your center. During waking state, your energy, you, what you think as you, your identity will be centered on the Ajna Chakra, eyes. That is why 80% of the connection, relationship between you and the world happens through eyes. Whenever I want to tell people, be still, I'll just tell them, close your eyes. The moment they close the eyes, they automatically become still. When they come and talk to me, I can't tell, close your mouth. I just tell them, close your eyes. No, really. And I have seen automatically they close their mouth. Telling close your mouth looks very disrespectful. Feels very hurting the ego. If I just say, close your eyes, without even their knowledge, they'll just close their mouth also. They'll close everything. Because the relationship happens only through eyes. Understand? Only through eyes. So, in the dream state, your identity exists in the throat center, Vishuddhi Chakra. That is why, unless you relax your throat, neck, you can't fall asleep. Even lying down, keep the neck straight, you will only feel uncomfortable. And trying to fall asleep, you will never be able to fall asleep. If you relax the neck, even if you are sitting, you will be sleeping. That you know, all of you. So, that there is no need for. All our schools and universities train you how to sit and sleep. Or how to keep your eyes open and not be attentive or aware of what is going on in the front. Now really, I have seen. Eyes will be wide open. Mouth also will be wide open. and they will be in samadhi. Really? No, but because of my experience in last 5 years with people, all kinds of people, I have seen almost all possible types of sleepings. All possible variety of sleepings. And the moment you relax your neck, whatever you may be doing, you will fall asleep. You may not go to the deep sleep, but you will fall into the dream state. Because this is the area, the moment it's relaxed, it just automatically pulls, attracts your identity. Your identity will come and stay in this. In the deep sleep state, it goes to Anagata Chakra. Understand? In waking state, Anya. In dream state, Vishuddhi. In deep sleep, Anahata. One important thing, when you are falling beyond this three state, Turiya, it goes to Anandaganda. It goes deeper than Anahata, Anandaganda Chakra. Means below the Anahata, above the Manipuraka. This is the way the consciousness, the identity travels. Your identity travels. Here, Mahadeva is giving a wonderful idea with intensity, with Sangalpa, putting the identity back to Anandaganda. Understand? Consciously, if you put your identity back into Anahata, automatically you will fall into Anandaganda. Even if you push up to the level of Anahata, means consciously falling into the silence, you will automatically fall into Anandaganda. That is why, understand one important thing, many people ask me, why do I fall asleep during meditation? Because you have to crash sleep and reach the meditation. It is on the way and you feel like you reached. Because always, either you know this or that. See, either you know Anya or Vishuddhi. Maximum Anahata, but Anahata you will not be aware. You never know Anandaganda, deeper than that. That is why on the way you feel, oh, the place feels very good. Why to travel too much? Now I am also feeling a little tired. Let me have a little rest, then we will start. And that is the way you end up. On the way, resting time, naturally, you miss the purpose or the idea. You heard that there is a wonderful story. The young age, all the kids will learn this story in the school. There was one guy who was selling the hat. He will walk from his village to the market. On the way, he was resting under a tree with a basket of hats, and all the monkeys which was in the tree, they all came and caught hold of one on a hat. When he woke up, he saw there was no hat left. And he just danced and monkeys also danced. He just jumped and monkeys also jumped. He threw the hat and all the monkeys threw the hat. And he collected all the hats and went away and sold. This is the only part story you know. There is one more version. There is a second edition. Anyhow, he went and sold the hat. And he died, his son also came, and his son did the same job of selling the hats, and he also died. The third generation, grandson, that guy came. He is also in the same business of selling the caps. He makes the cap and he is going to the same market, and he is resting under the same tree. As usual, the same way, all the monkeys have picked up his caps. And he wakes up, he sees all the monkeys are wearing. Now he thinks he knows the technique. He knows the technique, he just jumps. All the monkeys are jumping. He dances, all the monkeys are dancing. He throws the cap. Suddenly he sees one monkey which was there without cap. He came and just took the cap and ran away. Then this guy started shouting, no, this is not fair. How come you guys are now changing the game? When I throw the cap back, you are supposed to throw all the caps. That is the way you did with my grandfather. And beautifully that leader of the monkey group says, you did not learn from your grandfather, but we learned from our grandfather. Understand? You did not learn from your grandfather, we learned from our grandfathers. Anyhow, if you sleep on the way, this is the drama you will go through. At least now, learn. Stop sleeping on the way. When you are traveling, the Vishuddhi is like a tree. It will really feel like, why not rest? But if you rest, sometime you lose the cap, sometime you may lose even the head. So, you do not know which one you will lose. Mahadeva is giving a very powerful technique. Just through intense intention, Satya Sangalpa, understand? There are different Sangalpas. Sangalpa, which does not have your conscious support behind, is a Mithya Sangalpa, waste intention, useless, energy waste, time waste. Sangalpa, which has your intention, your conscious support behind, is Satya Sangalpa. If you have Satya Sangalpa, means ready to go into that experience of enlightenment, courage to go through, desire, intense desire to get enlightenment, courage to go through the process, then this technique is for you. Let me describe. Mahadeva says, touching eyeballs as a feather, is asking to touch the eyeballs, means the place where your consciousness resides during waking state. After closing the eyes, just touch the eyeballs as a feather. You can even use the feather. One important thing is the feather should not bend. If it bends, naturally you are putting too much pressure. Too much pressure will not work here. You need to put right pressure. It's like a Literally, it's like a playing the veena. Neither less pressure nor low, no more pressure. If it is a less, then you will not be able to create the sound. If it is too tight, if the strings are too tight, the pressure is more, again, it will break. You need to give exact pressure. Actually, this balancing itself will take at least 1 month. Balancing, actually, what Mahadeva does, how much intensity you have on your identity and how much intensity you have on the world. See, your personality, your being shares half energy on your ego, half energy on your world. The I carries half energy, mind carries half energy. If the mind carries more energy, you will be completely materialistic. Working, 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 you will never like vacation. Workaholic. You will die by working. Means the mind, your wealth carries more of your attention than you yourself. I have seen people in the beginning, they will start working for wealth. And after that, even if they have wealth, they will not know how to enjoy. And they will be continuously working because it has become a habit. They will just create wealth. Initially they will start creating wealth to enjoy. After some time, the idea to enjoy will disappear. Just wealth, wealth, wealth. What for? Just to leave everything and die. Too much of energy invested on the mind. And if the person is too much invested on mind, he will create wealth, he will not enjoy. If he is too much invested on the eye, he will be egoistic, but will not have anything around him. The empty poets, or not even poets, poets will be very sensitive. Empty intellectuals will have a tall talk. They know how to talk for 20 hours, but they will not even have how to be practical to raise their next meal. The eye-centered, mind-centered. Mahadeva is real here, giving a technique to balance a person who is exactly balancing the eye-centered and mind-centered, will become enlightened. Balancing between eye and mind is what Mahadeva is teaching here, because Your eyes are representative of I. That is why it is called I. And your hands are representative of the energy towards the world. The energy which you put towards the world, your hands represent. The energy which you put on you, your eyes represent. When you balance both of them, kind of a connection starts happening between two. The energy balance between I and mine will happen. You will fall into the center. Understand? I can say this is one of the powerful technique to awaken the Kundalini Shakti. The potential energy which you are carrying. It's a, one of the powerful tantric technique. Not only I myself practiced in my life, I have seen people who practice this technique enter into the higher consciousness very quickly, because it needs a lot of attention. You are bound to be experiencing the truth. It's like a, if your place is near to the city, you have to be legal, just like we. Whatever we do, city will know. We have to be completely compliant with the city's needs. Same way, this technique is a foolproof technique. In this technique, everything has to be in shape, because the technique itself is so powerfully designed. When you are touching the eyeballs like a feather, understand, lightness between them opens. You should be touching, but you should not be touching. It's like a, your fingers should be very close, but not pressing it. If you balance and just put your hand slowly, 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 you will see it takes a lot of time, because your hands will be shaking first. And either you will touch strongly or lightly, or you may not touch. By the time you balance, at least 20 minutes per day you have to balance. You have to try with one finger, Sambhavi Mudra. The Shiva describes this as a Shambhavi Mudra. With that, just, actually Shambhavi Mudra is like this, but you can try with the simple one, two hands, two finger, supporting on the face, you can try. When you try to touch like a feather, slowly you will see a kind of a strong energy connection getting built between the finger and the eyes. What exactly has to happen, you know? You should feel the eyes, hands, finger also has become part of the eyes. As on now, when you close your eyes, you will feel your boundary is ending inside the... The moment you close the eyes, your boundary ends in the eyelids. But you should touch it with so much, such a soft way, your eyes should feel it has expanded. Your eyes should feel the same sensitivity which you feel inside the eyes in the fingers also. Actually, it is a very beautiful technique to develop the sensitivity in your whole body. Practically, you will feel the same sensitivity which you are having in the eyeballs, in the nails. Understand? You have to be so sharp in your sankalpa, so subtle in your visualization. As on now, the intense life which you feel inside your eyeballs and the life which you feel on your nails, just compare. Your nails are practically dead. You don't feel life in the nails. But you feel a strong sensitivity or life in the eyes. Mahadeva is saying, bring that same sensitivity to the nails. Make your finger feel connected. Not only feel connected, feel the same sensitivity of the eyeballs. It's like a, your eyes are always outgoing. Half of the consciousness is on your eye, half is on mine. When you close the eyes and touch, make the finger sensitive, feel connected, it looks very illogical. How can this lead to enlightenment? you will start seeing the energy circles inside you instead of outgoing. Understand? If you close it, the outgoing will stop, but inside it will be getting wasted. You will see too many scenes. If you block it with the eyes and feel the hands also sensitive, like eyeballs, you will stop seeing the scenes even inside. This is the logic how the technique works. Enlightenment will happen if you stop seeing in outside and inside. If you close your eyelids, you will stop seeing outside, but you will continue to see inside. The TV which cannot be switched off is there, doing all comedy shows and all serials, whole day going on. And whether it is a daytime or night time, some serial or comedy show is going on. And sometime 2-3 show goes on. That is the dangerous part. 2-3 shows at a time in same screen. That is the worst part. That is the worst part. And I have seen some of the comedy lines. If a agriculture show related to agriculture and the show related to beautifying, if both are mixed on each other, what will happen? Please plow the land and apply the powder. Add little cream, then put little pesticide and dig it deep and put the covering paste, then add lipstick, remove the mud. Both will create a big mess. That is what is exactly going on inside TV continuously. You do not know whether it is beautician course or agriculture work. You do not know whether you are learning farming or beautifying yourself. And finally you end up in what beauty we are carrying. Finally we end up in this mess. Switching off that inside TV, that will happen through this technique. When you close your eyes and put the fingertip on the eyeballs and feel, put your attention between the eyeballs and the fingertips and feel connected and make the fingertips also as sensitive as eyeballs, your whole attention and energy will be balanced, will not have energy left for seeing inside TV. The comedy show will be switched off. And there will not be any movements inside your inner space. Suddenly you will see, you fall into the center. You fall into the silence. You fall into the thoughtless state. There is no scene outside or inside. The seer is awakened. Whenever the seeing stops and the scene stops, the seer is awakened. By closing the eyes, scene stops. By putting the fingertips on the eyes and feeling connected stops the seeing process, naturally the seer is awakened. When the seer is awakened, you are Rishi. That is why Rishi is called seer. Mantra drashta, who sees mantra, is Rishi. Means who experiences mantra is Rishi. Understand? It's a very powerful technique. Try in the home. It takes at least half an hour, even once, to balance. I've tried. Now trying will not work. Don't bother. It takes half an hour. Try in the home. At least it will take 1 month. But I can say, 1 month is too less time to balance yourself. To balance yourself. Try in the home. You will see the seeing will disappear into seer. Let you all achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nithyananda. Thank you.